Karen Beaumont, a software analyst from Havant. Jenny La Grande, an aerobics teacher from Hammersmith. Tracey Harris, a fitness instructor from Brighton. And Ludwig Ramsey, a fireman from Andover. Tonight face the ultimate challenge, the might of the gladiators. Jet. Warrior. Lightning. Shadow. Cobra. Panther. Wolf. Flame. Hawk. Phoenix. Saracen and Scorpio. Coming to you from the National Indoor Arena in Birmingham, here are the presenters of Gladiators, John Fashnu and Ulrika Johnson.
Hello and a very, very warm welcome to Gladiators. Tonight, our four contenders will once again face the might of our gladiators in a series of six different events. Using their physical fitness and agility, they'll hope to gain as many points as possible to give them an advantage in our sudden death eliminator at the end of the show. And the winner of that, of course, will hope for a place in our semi-finals.
And naturally, the winners of our semis will go through to meet the gladiators in the finals, where the highest scoring male and female contenders will share a grand prize of £10,000.
Let's meet our first female contender. She is Karen Beaumont. Hello, Karen. What a fantastic smile. You're looking raring to go.
I certainly am.
You're a software analyst. Who do you work for?
I work for IBM.
And what are you doing at the moment?
I'm working on a multi-million pound project as a technical coordinator.
Goodness me, that must be quite stressful and demanding, is it?
Yes, it is.
So how do you switch off from that, and how do you sort of get away from that and keep fit?
Well, I do it by riding my horse in the evenings and weight training, and then I cycle to work and I run around the lake at lunchtimes.
Well done, Karen. You look very fit indeed. Certainly a challenge for our gladiators. Off to your atlasphere, Karen Beaumont.
And the second of our female contenders is Jenny La Grande. Now, Jenny, you're a fitness instructor. What else do you do?
I don't do anything else apart from train all the time. That's my way of relaxing.
That's your way of relaxing, training?
Yeah.
Well, how do you get a body like that?
I do bodybuilding as well.
Well, give us a pose. Well, with a body like that, I don't think there's going to be many gladiators who are going to give you any problems at all. Off to your atlasphere. Thank you, Jenny.
First event is called Atlaspheres, and this rather huge round cage is what we call an atlasphere. Our contenders will climb inside that atlasphere, which is 7 foot in diameter, and then they'll attempt to score as many points as they can in 60 seconds by rolling the atlasphere onto the arena floor and across the four scoring pods.
The score is registered every time a bottom of a contender's atlasphere rolls over one of these four pods and triggers off a sensor which releases a plume of CO2, just like this. And every time a contender's atlasphere hits one of those sensors, that scores 3 points.
And of course, we couldn't do this without the help of our two gladiators. They are tonight Panther.
Panther's favorite events are duel and atlaspheres, where her game plan is to slink down the ramp and then pounce on the contenders. She's the current holder of the Miss Russia title and has the perfect figure, 36, 25, 36.
And Lightning.
Lightning describes herself as a jack-of-all-trades. She thrives on all events, an accomplished gymnast and former member of the junior British team. She keeps her 38, 26, 35 figure in shape with bodybuilding. Our first contender is Karen Beaumont, also a bodybuilder, came sixth in the Miss England Championships. She bought her own horse last year called Montego Bay, Monty for short. Her ambition is to represent England in the dressage at the next Olympics. Another bodybuilder, Jenny La Grande, teaches aerobics and fitness. Here's how she feels about our first event.
Well, my favourite event is the atlasphere, because it's fast and basically once you got down there, you just go for it. I just love it.
Well, Jenny's aboard. All the girls are loaded up into their atmospheres and ready to rock and roll. And so that crowd, they're cooking. Our referee is John Anderson.
Ready!
Olympic coach of the year, 1988, says of Gladiators, it's in every way as legitimate as any of the Olympic disciplines or sports he's coached. And John has coached most of them at the last five Olympics.
3, 2, 1!
As our Iron Maidens thunder down the ramps, Karen and Jenny have got 60 seconds to score as many times as they can by running their spheres over the scoring pods. Oh, no, you don't want to do that. Jenny and Karen collide, nearly totaling each other. Let's say Panda and Lightning a job. They both break away now. Karen on pod 3 scores 3 points there. Jenny boxed in. There's Karen in red, making another breakthrough by the look of it. Good break this. We have a breakaway. Coming up on pod 4. She gets it. 3 points. Panther body checking Jenny. Move for move there. Jenny's size working against her. Those atmospheres 7 feet in diameter take great strength to get them going from a standing position anyway. Lightning off, slams into her, sends her flying. We're out of time here. Karen picks up 6 points, Jenny none. In the replay, she was outmaneuvered and outpowered by Panther and Lightning. There's Panther, having been spun around in that tumble dryer. Lightning continues her role with a tumble for the crowd. After the first event, Karen's on 6, Jenny yet to get off the mark.
And once again, it's time for our clash of the titans. It's our male contenders, Tracey Harris. Yourself,
sorry, I always wanted to do that.
Well, you've done it now, so now you have to behave. Tracey, no surprises, you're a fitness instructor.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I work and train at Withdean Stadium in Brighton.
Right, enough of that. None of them are here, obviously. Now tell us, you're also a triathlete. What does that involve?
For triathlon, I do the full distance, which involves swimming 2.5 miles, cycling 112 miles, and then running a marathon back to back.
That's what I do before I get up in the morning. So tell us a little bit about your ambition. It's not really to just be a fitness instructor, is it?
Well, no, that's right. Before triathlon, I was training for film and TV stunt work. Did all the disciplines, no problem, but couldn't get an equity card.
Well, tonight you're certainly going to do lots of stunts against our gladiators. So off to your atmosphere, Tracey Harris.
And the second of our male contenders is Ludwig Ramsey. Now, Ludwig, you're a fireman. How long have you been a fireman?
Well, I've been with Hampshire Fire Brigade 4 years now.
4 years. Now, you must have seen some horrific sights in 4 years.
You do, but it's part of the job. You just got to carry on with it.
So what do you do to relax and get away from it all?
Well, just get out in there and go running.
Where do you run?
Just around Hampshire and over I live in, so mostly around the streets.
Running with anyone famous lately?
Well, when I was younger, I used to be with Linford Christie. Did a bit of running with him.
Well, everybody here seems to be in the fitness business. I mean, are you a bodybuilder?
No, I just do running. That's all I do.
Well, it might just pay off being a little bit small in some of these events later on. So wish you all the best and over to your atmosphere.
Tracey and Ludwig are now facing Warrior.
And for all you younger viewers, now you know why Mummy keeps telling you to eat your greens. Warrior's intake, 10,000 calories a day. He's the biggest gladiator in the business, and atmospheres is his favourite event.
And Shadow.
Shadow's a big fella too, and should prove to be the ultimate challenge to our contenders. He's powerful and very fast, and on atmospheres, he told me, they'll regret the day they get in Shadow's way. Now, is Tracey fazed by those big fellas?
Hey, I don't think they're big, but they're not that tough. I mean, I think given the right opportunity, I can definitely kick their butt.
Well, I hope he's got a long reach because he's giving away 5 inches in height and 9 stone in weight.
Tracy's a triathlete. He said earlier he has to cycle 112 miles and then swim 2.5 miles and then run a full marathon, all back-to-back. Ludwig proving that size isn't everything. He managed the most chin-ups of any contender in our qualifiers, 50. Our Hampshire fireman is confident he'll have the support of all firemen up and down the country. Working in such a demanding profession, he knows all about digging deep into that courage bank and reaching for that little bit extra. He's feisty, he's fast, and he's ready for atmospheres.
Contenders, ready!
Atlaspheres makes rollerball look like a game of marbles. Thunderball at the Thunder Dome. Contender collision. And there goes Shadow into Tracy. And now he's picking on Ludwig, a man literally half his size as Ludwig steams across pot four, picks up a goal, 3 points. And down the other end, Tracy, 3 points there as Warrior's hot on his case. And another goal, 3 points again. This point-scoring powerhouse motoring across yet another pod, another 3 points there. Tremendous scoring here. And there he goes, Ludwig across two. No cigar, there's Tracy settling in on four, another 3 points. Ludwig, 3 points there. And look at this, double-teaming the Warrior. Shadow to the rescue. Oh, look at that, takes him out and spins. Oh, tremendous goal over there by Ludwig. Fantastic scoring. Ludwig 9, Tracy 12. Good job, guys.
Ludwig does well to find the space and squeeze in on pod 3 with Shadow right on his tail. And there's Warrior. Another busy day at the office.
Shadow, comrades in arms.
And after 60 seconds of thrills behind those grills, here's how the scores have shaken down. Tracy 12, Ludwig 9.
Our second event is called the wall. This is where two contenders have to simultaneously climb 36 feet right to the top, and they've got just 60 seconds to do it.
Don't forget now that after 20 seconds climbing time, two of our gladiators will be hot on their heels, trying to wrench them from the face of the wall. And of course, failure for a contender will be when they are wrenched away from the wall and drop down. But don't worry, of course, they're all wearing safety harnesses.
For Karen Beaumont, the only way is up, and trying to drag her down will be Phoenix. Phoenix maintains that perfect body with a healthy diet consisting of low fat, high carbohydrate, and high protein intake. Jenny can count on the support of her mates from the gym. She'll need it when Scorpio scuttles up behind her. Scorpio maintains her powerful frame with 6 hours preparation each day. A former high jump champion and talented gymnast, she's more than qualified to tackle the wall. A daunting experience looking up at that 36-foot wall. Both Karen and Jenny focused on this awesome challenge.
Contenders will go on my first whistle. Gladiators will go on the second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Jenny and Karen looking to capitalize upon that 20 seconds head start. Remember, it's 10 points for reaching the summit, 5 points if they're still on the wall after the 60 seconds time limit. And as they say, it's tough at the top. But on the wall, it's tougher getting up there, particularly when you've got Phoenix and Scorpio hot on your heels. Here comes trouble. Phoenix and Scorpio have to make up some ground here. And Jenny nearly there. Remember, she's got to get her feet over the top there to pick up those 10 points. She gets an arm over. Scorpio's right behind her. Oh, she's been grabbed. She's in Scorpio's clutches. Can she hang on to pick up her 5 points? Karen outpaces Phoenix comfortably. She's exhausted, but she's on top. The full 10 points. Jenny still struggling with Scorpio. What a tug of war. There's the whistle. She's made it. She deserves those 5 points. Oh. And you can see here from our privileged position, Jenny did well to hang on. The helmet camera showing Scorpio certainly getting to grips with her.
Karen, that really was terrific. How do you feel?
Oh, elated. I'm so pleased.
Were you frightened at all at the beginning? I know you have a slight fear of being chased.
That's absolutely right. I love the war, but I hate being chased. It's the worst nightmare.
Did you look back at all?
Yes, I did. I was terrified, but I kept going.
Will you be pleased to know you've got 10 points?
Great, thank you.
Well, Jenny, great contest. You nearly got there. You got 5 points. How was it up there?
It was all right. I thought I got it, but she got me. And I'm mad.
After two events, Karen climbs to 16 and Jenny hangs 5. Well, Wolf eyeballs Tracy. Will you marry me? Well, Wolf says, I'm not a pushover. Tracy says, nor am I. Well, the vicar's turned up. John Fashnew bravely stepping in, looking to settle out of court.
Nice. Loosen up. Early days. That's better.
And while the dust settles, our fireman Ludwig wishing he had a ladder.
And the first of our male contenders is Tracy! And after 15 seconds, he's going to be chased by the wolf!
And if you go down to the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. One look at those stats is enough to bring tears to a contender's eyes.
The second of our male contenders is Ludwig! Yeah! And right up behind him is the might of Saracen!
So, Saracen looking to dominate Ludwig with his superior height and body weight. Ludwig giving away 1 foot in height and 8 stone in weight.
On my first whistle, contenders will go. On my second whistle, Gladiators! 3, 2, 1!
Tracy and Ludwig pumped up. They'll be in a hurry to get up that wall, knowing that in 15 seconds our referee will release Saracen and the wolf after them. And Ludwig told me his ambition is to run faster. I'd change that to climb faster. Here they come. Oh, Ludwig's lost his grip and his points. Nearly his pants. Tracy, a man on a mission. There's bad blood between him and Wolf. But it looks like he's going to give him the slip. He's done it. 10 points. The Wolfman won't be amused.
Tracy, well done. Well done. That was a fantastic climb. How do you feel?
I feel great. All I wanted to do was get that wolf.
I saw you psyching each other up at the beginning. What was going through your mind?
I just wanted to kill him.
There's no need for that. He was just behind you.
Him and Saracen have been giving me some serious ear bending all week. I just wanted to show him a lesson on the wall. I didn't care which one it was. It was either one. I didn't care, but I've done it.
Listen, you're here. You've scored 10 points. Well done.
Thanks.
Now, can you remind us all, Ludwig, what is your job?
I'm a fireman.
Pardon?
I'm a fireman.
You're a fireman? So you do know the whole world was watching that?
Yes, they were, but it's not a ladder. If it was a ladder, I would have been up there like a shot.
Well, let's not be too hard on him. Firemen don't usually have gladiators to contend with.
Wolf, can we have a chat with you?
Well, Wolf, a man of few words. So after two events, Tracy climbs to 22, Ludwig left dangling on 9. Event 3 is Danger Zone, our 60-second game of hit or be hit, requiring quick feet and rapid reactions. That's the target to hit, which is situated above the gladiator. Contenders have 4 attempts to hit that target via the 4 weapon stations, 1 point for each weapon fired, or 10 points for a bullseye. If after firing all 4 weapons they still haven't hit the target, they can scramble through the perspex cylinder, punch a lower target, which will light up and send the gladiator flying. Karen's first.
Well, the reason we call this event Danger Zone is because it's protected by one of our gladiators who will be firing tennis balls at 100 miles an hour at our contenders. Our first gladiator tonight is Jets!
And Jets certainly got the power. Firepower. She's ready to strut her stuff. A professional dancer, which helps to maintain that fabulous figure. Karen will certainly dance to her tune.
Contender, ready! Three, two, one.
Oh, Karen, obviously a big fan of Cagney and Lacey, rolls to the first weapon, the crossbow. She has 10 seconds to release it before that station self-destructs. Picks up a point for that, moves on to the second weapon, the bazooka. Oh, good shot, she's getting her eye in. Moves on to number three, the mortar. Oh, she's picked off by Jet. Jet's got her eye in. Jet notches up another one. That was quick. Let's see where she got her in the replay. And look at that. Jess gets her on the leg there. I bet that stung. Picks up 2 points, though. Next up is Jenny.
Contender, ready! Ready! Three, two, one.
Well, Jenny will be looking to pick up maximum points. She's trailing Karen at this stage. And Jet, a deadly shot, picked off Karen in no time at all. Remember, Jet has got to get a direct hit. Ricochets or deflections don't count. Oh, look at that. Jenny proves to be a hot shot Top Gun. Delighted with that result. Oh. Jet goes up. And Jenny pulls back some deficit, a lap of honour as well, reducing Karen's lead to 3 points. Karen 18, Jenny 15. Tracey all kitted up in his body armour, head guard and PEPs, personal eye protectors. Tracey faces the Hawk, or Hawkeye, as he's proven to be on this event. This deadly shot comes fully equipped with this impressive armoury and that Clint Eastwood smile.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready! Three, two, one!
So Tracey steps into the danger zone. Look like dance steps. Oh, this is Gladiators, not Come Dancing. First weapon's the crossbow, 10 seconds to get it off. Well, that was close. He's been baiting the wolf, and now it looks like he's trying to hang out on the hawk. All this bravado is costing his time. Remember, the station self-destructs. You don't release them in 10 seconds. This is one confident hombre. Tracey wants to be a stuntman. This is more like a rehearsal for Singing in the Rain than for Rambo, though. Lets off the mortar. It's onto the rocket launcher, if he ever gets there. Oh, that counts. It's a bullseye. Tracey hangs up the hawk. Certainly going to ruffle his feathers. Tracy's gladiated him. Next up, Ludwig, who on paper should do well. He's got quick feet. He used to train with Linford Christie, and he's
Contender,
no slouch.
Ready!
Ludwig has 60 seconds to get the job done. He needs a big hit to keep up with Tracey, who shot into a commanding lead. Using those shields well on the crossbow. 1 point for every weapon fired, 10 points for a bullseye. Weapon two, the bazooka. Oh, that's a better shot. Moves for the mortar. Oh, Hawk picks him off. That was fast. Ludwig didn't know what hit him. Well, Hawk evens the score. Let's see where he got him. This is an incredible shot. As you can see, Ludwig is a rolling target, and Hawk picks him off with a leg shot in mid-roll. Good job, Hawkeye. After three events, Tracey notches up 32, and Ludwig trails on 11.
So, still to come, three more thrilling and demanding events before that all-important and physically agonizing eliminator. So join us after the break when our contenders once again will face the ultimate challenge of our gladiators!
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena. And after three grueling events, the scores stand like this.
Well, in the women's contest, it's a very, very tight fight between Karen and Jenny. Karen's on 18 and Jenny's on 15. In the men's contest, Tracy's well ahead of Ludwig. He's on 32, leaving Ludwig trailing on 11.
Event four is called Swing Shot. As you can see, the contenders are on their platforms, 15 feet above the ground. They have to jump down to the floor, suspended by their shot cords, bounce back up, and attempt to catch one of three different colored balls. Yellow equals 1 point, blue equals 2 points, and red equals 3 points.
Tonight, they are facing Flame.
And Flame blazing hot tonight. 6 feet tall and 10 stone, which gives her more bounce to the ounce.
And Phoenix.
Contenders, ready!
Jenny and Karen have 60 seconds to pick off those balls from that center cylinder and deposit them in their scoring baskets atop the platforms.
Ready.
Phoenix and Flame will make like Tarzan and Jane and block them out of the game.
3, 2, 1.
Swing out, sisters. They fly through the air with the greatest of ease. Jenny and Karen both picking off in yellow. Oh, Jenny throws her yellow at the basket. That's not allowed. Might work for the Harlem Globetrotters, but not on Swing Shot. You have to return to your platform and deliver by hand. Oh, a yellow there. That was crafty. Karen gets a yellow. That's 1 point. That's how you do it. All the way to the penthouse. Comes the fly to the Phoenix. Oh, she blocks her out. Body checks Karen out of the blue. Remember, gladiators cannot kick or aim headshots or strip balls from the cylinder. There goes Jenny. Up she goes for a blue. Jenny's shot cord, like all the others, specially adjusted to her individual body weight. And she's finding her re-entry to the launch pad a bit of a problem at the moment. While Jenny hangs around. Phoenix and Flame double team on Karen. Body checking her out of the game there. Jenny comes back down, out of reach that time. Looks like we're going to be out of time as well. And after four events and those poor pickings, it's still close. Karen on 20, Jenny on 17. It's the guys' turn to swing their thing. Tracy and Ludwig are jumping up against the high-flying Hawk and Wolf, that wild thing. And there's some scores to be settled. Remember, Tracy is tangled with Hawk and Wolf, coming off better in both the wall and danger zone. Tracy, no need for me to tell you. Hell hath no fury like a gladiator scorned. There's the Hawk.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready! Three, two, one!
It's swing time. 60 seconds of high-flying dogfights. Tracy picks off a yellow, and Ludwig comes away empty-handed. Ludwig, a fireman, more used to sliding down a pole than jumping up at one. Tracy gets his in the bank. Oh, he's short there, short of the mark. Yet to get the measure of this event. Ludwig takes a flyer. Remember, it don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. He's got a blue. Now he's got his rhythm. A blue for Blue Watch, 2 points. It's another blue for Ludwig. He's definitely got rhythm and blues. Up he goes, and another blue. There's no stopping this man, and another blue. Oh, the ball's falling on the floor there. Once they hit the floor, they're out of play. Oh, looks like they're a little tangled up at the moment. They can't come to the phone. Hawk and Wolf will be pleased with that. There they are, the oldest swingers in town. Ludwig's big scoring has pulled back some of Tracy's lead. And after four events, Tracy 33, Ludwig 17.
Hang tight. Tough is the name of event five. These rings, as you can see, are suspended from the ceiling, 4 feet apart and 10 feet above the arena floor. Our contender will start from this end of the playing area and has to swing across to the opposite platform, ring by ring, and that's a whole 50 feet. Now, that's tough enough in itself, but just imagine if you're faced by a gladiator coming the other way with the express intention of wrenching you off the rings by means of pulling or perhaps even prising your hands off. Now, the gladiators are not allowed to resort to headlocks, and no tickling either.
This event requires a lot of arm power and upper body strength. On the platform over here, we have Karen. And trying to wrench her off on the other platform, we have Jet.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready!
So let's take our ringside seats for Hang Tough. Now, Karen ideally looking to get a touchdown on Jet's platform and get a full 10 points. Or if she can make it into the scoring zone and hang on till whistle time, she'll pick up 5. Good determination in both of their faces. You don't want to do that. You don't want to turn your back on Jet, Karen. Oh, she's quick to exploit mistakes. Locked onto the target like a heat-seeking missile. What a vice-like grip. Strips them right off the rings. She's got you, baby. Come on down. Another one bites the dust. Oh, look at that. A reverse victory roll there from Jet. See how she zeroes in on Karen. Won't release the ring until she's sure that she's got her. It's a textbook splashdown. And Karen eats Matt.
Contender, ready!
Our next contender, Jenny La Grande.
Gladiator, ready! Three, two, one!
So it's Jenny and the Jet. And this is Jenny's least favorite event. She managed 43 push-ups in the qualifiers, so she's got the good upper body strength, but she's going to need something extra special to outflank the Jet. Jet's got a blue, she's in the scoring zone, but that's really where Jenny needs to be. And this is more like hang loose than hang tough. Jenny making no positive attempt to move to another ring. You can hang in there if you're in the scoring zone. Or in direct conflict with a gladiator, you can't just wait for them to come to you. Well, she's hung there for more than 10 seconds. Surely the referee will disqualify her. And Jet having to make all the moves. Not quite able to find the right final approach. I don't think it'll make any difference. She's out of time. She's disqualified. No points. What a great aerial display by Jet. She maintains her 100% track record. So no points there for Jenny or Karen. And after 5 events, the scores are still Karen 20, Jenny 17. So it's Tracey Harris's turn to hang tough. His girlfriend Jane and his mum kept pestering him to enter Gladiators, and they're in the audience tonight cheering their support. Saracen thrives on this event. He says the faster they come at me, the better.
Contender, ready!
So Tracy waging his own personal battle against our gladiators, and this time he's got a real fight on his hands. Tracy told me that if he wins the prize money, he owes the bank manager 1,500 quid, so his bank manager will be rooting for him. And I suppose if he loses, he'll be shooting for him. Saracen and Tracy eyeing each other up, each waiting for the other to commit themselves one way or the other.
one-handed Saracen back onto two. Tracey cannot hang there any longer. He's not in the scoring zone, and he's been there more than 10 seconds. Surely he must be disqualified. He must get hold of a blue ring. Makes a move on a blue, it's too late. Time up. And if we check out the replay, we'll see how Tracey makes the move on that blue ring, but it just slips out of his fingers on the whistle. A second quicker, and he would have snatched those 5 points.
Contender! Ready!
Ludwig could do with the points here. Tracey didn't make it, so if he picks up 10 here, it could really be handy before going into duel.
Ready!
Ludwig giving away 9 inches in height and 6 stone in weight to Saracen. But as I said earlier, tremendous upper body strength. Ludwig, ex-REF, so he'll be used to aerial combat. Oh, Ludwig banks left, and he tries a fly past on the Saracen. And Saracen left one-handed. Can he get to the next ring? Oh, out of the blue, Saracen moves in. He's got him. Oh, look at that. That looked dodgy to me. That looked like a headlock with the legs. The rules clearly say no headlocks, no striking out, and that looked like a headlock to me. But how does the guy hang on? I told you he was strong. What a job he's doing. Saracen can't believe it. What? Oh, he brings him down, but surely the referee has called it a foul. Let's take a closer look. And as you can clearly see, Saracen's legs lock around Ludwig in a dangerous headlock. And that is not allowed in Hang Tough. Let's get the official word. Let's join John Anderson.
Headlocks are not allowed. Saracen used a headlock. Saracen is therefore disqualified. The contender gains 10 points.
Well, Ludwig, the big man's been disqualified. Do you think you'd have made it otherwise?
Yeah, I definitely would have made it. My point situation was really bad, and I had to get across. And, you know, all I had in my mind was just to get across.
I mean, what was it like when he was hanging on you?
Well, I had one hand at one stage on the ring, and I just couldn't feel anything. All I just felt was I had to hold on.
Well, Saracen, you were disqualified. Our referee, John Anderson, said it was wrong to hang on. What have you got to say about it?
Well, I mean, he put up a great fight. I understand he reckons he would have got across, but I don't think so. I caught him, but we had a good fight. My legs went around his neck. I accept the decision.
So the referee's decision going in Ludwig's favour. After 5 events, Tracey 33, Ludwig 27. Event 6 is duel. Now, victory in this event is worth 10 points. That's if you KO the gladiator. If you last the distance without dropping your pugil stick, stepping across or being knocked off, you pick up 5.
Contender, ready!
So it's Karen Beaumont giving away 7 inches and 1 stone to her opponent.
Gladiator, ready!
A mighty flame!
On guard!
There's not much room for manoeuvre on those platforms. 4 feet in diameter, 16 inches apart. You need balance as well as timing and upper body strength.
3, 2, 1!
Karen giving away that height and weight. And my tip to the smaller contenders is to hang back on the platform and draw them across. Flame giving it everything. Oh! Plenty of noise there from Karen. She takes the blows. Yes, she says. No, she says. Well, make your mind up. Oh, let it out, girl. And Flame swinging for keeps there. Making all the aggressive moves. Karen defends well. Lost the full 30. That's 5 points. And in the replay, Karen does a good defensive job, withstanding Flame's onslaught with grit and determination. 5 points the hard way.
Contender! Ready!
So Jenny La Grande stands up to the flame.
Gladiator, ready! On guard! 3, 2, 1!
Jenny, our little is dynamite in the fight of her life. 10 points for a KO, 5 for going the full 30. And Flame gets straight to work. It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it. And Jenny giving as good as she gets. This is not just about survival. Jenny's going for it. Flame lands a good combination. Come on, Jenny. Sneaks a roundhouse in. The Flame flickered then. She does it. Time up and 5 points. Jenny did a great job lifting that pugil stick, let alone swinging it. The circumference makes it difficult for the smaller ladies to get a grip on it. Good job there from Jenny. Enjoyed every moment of that. After 6 events, both ladies move up 5 points, but there's still only 3 in it. Karen 25, Jenny 22. Our next contender is Tracey Harris.
Contender, ready!
And he's definitely in the wrong weight division, giving away 3 inches in height and 7 stone.
Theater, ready!
There's the awesome and undefeated Shadow.
On guard!
What a gladiator, the only Shadow to cast people on the floor. Tracey slits at the Shadow. Is this a wise move? Shadow retaliates. He doesn't have to wait for an invitation to the party. Tracey taking a licking, but keeps on sticking. Shadow giving him one for Wolf, and there's one for Hawk, teaching him to have more respect for gladiators. It's hammer time! Oh, it's over. This is like something out of Rocky V, and we know the ending. Sent him into orbit. And while Tracey counts his lucky stars, let's have a look at that lethal combination again. Take that and that. It's the old hammer blow. I've lost count now. Tracy's out for it. Can hardly bear to watch. But as I'm the commentator, I'd better keep one eye open. This is the classic David and Goliath confrontation. A terrific mismatch in terms of body weight and height. Ludwig giving away 8 inches and 10 stone to the Terminator. The awesome Shadow. Whatever you do, don't blink. I hope he's paid up his insurance. Good luck, Ludwig.
Three, two, one.
Big or small, Shadow, they're all the same to him. He's got a job to do. I wonder what the bookies' odds would be on this one. Ludwig defends well, making himself an awkward target. Good tactics. He can keep this up. He may surprise us all yet. I shouldn't be such an optimist. Shadow draws him across. That's an instant DQ, no points. And while Tracey and Ludwig nurse those headaches, the scores don't change. Tracey 33, Ludwig 27. Give the man a pat on the back.
Whilst our contenders no longer have to face the might of the gladiators, they still have to face each other in our head-to-head eliminator. So don't go away now. Join us after the break. Indoor arena and to our physically agonizing eliminator. This is sudden death, ladies and gentlemen. As you know, whoever wins this will earn a place on our leaderboard. Karen's ahead by 3 points. Remember, each point is worth half a second, so therefore Karen gets a 1.5 second head start.
Well, Jenny, you've got a little tiny disadvantage.
Yeah.
You've seen the American Gladiators. What do you think of this one?
Well, it looked easy on TV, but honestly, trying it out is very, very hard.
Well, we wish you all the best.
Thank you very much.
Well, Karen, this is as close as we get on Gladiators to show jumping courses. This one, you're going to have to ride on your own without Monty, your horse. How are you going to do?
Well, I intend to hang in there and not fall off.
Well, I think that's simple enough, isn't it? I'll let you and Jenny get on with getting prepared for the eliminator. In the meantime, I'll hand you back to John Sachs.
Thanks, Ulrika. Here are the 9 obstacles Karen and Jenny will negotiate. It's 20 feet up the cargo net, then over, down the slide using your front or back, 9 feet of scramble sheet across the overhead traverse. Should a contender fall, there's a 10 seconds penalty. Bit of a twist, the rolling beams, they can send a contender flying in a number of directions. And it's onto our second cargo net, up to the platform. Then it's a white knuckle ride down the zip line, 90 feet onto the crash mats. Take a sharp left, punishing scramble up the awesome Travelator, then grab the rope through the paper burst and home free for a place on the leaderboard and a winner's medal.
Contenders, ready! Karen, you will start on my first whistle. Jenny, you will start on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1...
Well, there's not much in it. Karen's three-point lead gives her 1.5 second start time, but Jenny eating into that from the off. The eliminator will stretch them to the limit, drawing on every ounce of their stamina and chutzpah. But it's Jenny who goes down the slide first, closely followed by Karen. And Jenny attacks the overhead ladder, a very demanding obstacle, requiring great upper body strength. And it's neck and neck as they attack the rolling beam. This one's going right down to the line, and I wouldn't like to put money on this one. They're gonna reach the platform together. This is almost like synchronized eliminator. And Jenny pushing Karen out of the way. Get out of my way, she says. Eager to get to that zip line. She gets away first. Closely followed by a face full of mat there. This couldn't be more exciting. Now it's literally the first one up that Travelator. And look at Jenny go. Great aggression. Grabs the rope first, followed by Karen. A split second later, no photo finish, but ever so close. Fast time, 1 minute 13 seconds. Jumping for joy. And look at the replay. See how she powers up that Travelator. Jenny joins Nicola Borden on the leaderboard with 22 points.
Congratulations. Congratulations. How do you feel?
I can't say it. I feel great. Thank you.
Yes. Congratulations. You deserve that. It was a great contest.
Brilliant contest and brilliant person.
Great stuff.
Karen, you didn't quite make it.
No, that's right. It's really tough. But I just want to say thanks to all my trainers for this. To my boyfriend, Mark. I wouldn't be if it wasn't for him. And to Dennis and Derek who helped me train.
Well done, Karen. Well done.
Well, I didn't get a cuddle from Uli. Great contenders. It was close all the way. Now, in the men's, Tracey is 6 points in the lead. He gets 0.5 second start for each point, which means those 6 points give him a 3 second head start over Ludwig.
Contenders, ready! On my first whistle, Tracey will go. On my second whistle, Ludwig will go. 3, 2, 1!
Well, if Ludwig can take on the shadow, he can take on anything. But then, as a firefighter, bravery and courage are everyday words in his vocabulary. Tracey will be down first. He's got to get up the scramble sheets and onto that overhead bike, closely followed by Ludwig. Tracey giving it some, but look at Ludwig pump that hand bike. At last, an obstacle that suits his body weight. Tracey carrying an extra 2 stone. He's finally going a little tougher. And what do they call this man? The fly. He's already made short work of the rolling beam. He's up the cargo net. I can't keep up with him. Tracy's arrived, but Ludwig's left him behind in his wake. This is bread and butter stuff for the fireman. Look at that. Perfect landing. Look at the time. This one's going under a minute. Has he got the energy for the Travelator? Stumbles a bit there. Keep going, Trace. Keep going, Ludwig. Grabs the rope through the paper burst. Great time, 55 seconds. And here comes our Tracy. The eliminator has really taken it out of him. Grabs the rope, bursts through, great contender. A nice slide down. And this is where Ludwig had the eliminator course all sewn up. His incredible speed and great rhythm made short work of that overhead bike. And look at the difference in speed compared to Tracy. Looks like he's going in slow motion. Ludwig Ramsey joins Weininger Irvin on the men's leaderboard with 27 points.
Ludwig, congratulations. I think we all know why they call you the fly now.
Yeah. I just want two things to say. My daughter missed it over there. She's fast asleep. And the other thing, Saracen's going down next time on the rings. Going down.
Yes! Yeah. Thanks very much. Congratulations.
Tracy, I'm afraid at the end, you didn't quite make it.
Never mind. I've enjoyed it here. The atmosphere's been electric. And the people are awesome. I'll thank everybody for their cheering. It's been great.
Well
So it's good luck to Ludwig. Remember, it's the four highest scoring contenders who will go through to our semi-finals. In the event of a point draw, the contender with the fastest eliminated time will go through. Join us next week when four more contenders face the ultimate challenge, the might of...
Show Us Your Guns, American Ninja Warrior is new to challenge next. And new tonight at 9, take your seat to ringside for TNA Impact 2016.